Hello friends, I, Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today we'll talk about pointers and 2D arrays in C programming. These are the contents of our today's session, pointer and 2D arrays. For that, we need to recollect the concept of 2D array in C programming. Same, we need to recollect the concept of pointers in C programming, then we'll go for pointer and 2D arrays, which is heart of our today's session. Recollect the concept of 2D array in C. Two-dimensional array can be written as 2D array, like this. 2D array is nothing but the matrix or the table of rows and columns, or it is also an array of one-dimensional arrays, or we can say that set of one-dimensional arrays. Let's go through the example where the matrix 4 by 3 is declared with the set of 1D arrays. This is the first set, this one is the second set, third set and the fourth set. Four sets of 1D array. In every set there are three elements are declared in the given declaration. So other way around, we can say that this is the matrix declaration of four rows, and in every row there are three columns. So 4 by 3 array or a matrix is declared. How to access the array elements are nothing but the name of the matrix, name of the array, and I and J. I represents the row index, J represents the column index. With the nested for loops, the outer for loop will work for row, inner for loop will work for columns, and in this way we can access all array elements from our program. In this way, we can use the 2D array in our program. How this 2D array can be represented in the memory? First of all, how the 2D array is represented in the matrix form? There are 4 rows, there are 3 columns, and total 4 threes are 12 values are there in the matrix. All that 12 values are stored sequentially in the matrix by considering this is the declaration of an array using the row measure declaration. In the two ways the matrix can be represented in the memory, a row measure representation and a column measure representation. In this row measure declaration, row after row the memories get allotted. A first row, that is row 0, next second row, next third row, and a last row. In this way they are represented. For every row the three elements, three columns are used: column 0, column 1, column 2, again column 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2 and 0, 1, 2 respectively. These are nothing but the index locations. The first 0 is for row, second is for column. This is row index, this one is column index. So this 0, 0, 0 is nothing but for row 0, and 0, 1, 2 are nothing but the column numbers, column indices 0, 1 and 2 respectively. Same thing is there for all the remaining rows. These are the elements 1, 2, 3 for column 0, 4, 5, 6 for, sorry, 1, 2, 3 are for row 0, 4, 5, 6 are for row 1, 7, 8, 9 are for row 2, and 10, 11, 12 are for row 3 are declared. The last thing is address locations. 6, 5, 5, 1, 0 is the base address of the array. Next 1, 2, 1, 4, 1, 6, 1, 8, 20, 2, 0, 2, 2 and so on Are the address location, continuous address locations are utilized by the matrix 4 by 3. Now, let's recollect the concept of pointers in C. Pointer variable is declared with a asterisk symbol and it is holding the address of our ordinary variable I. J is a pointer variable and it is pointing to I by collecting, storing its address. This can be done with the help of this declaration. We need to remember that J should not be any ordinary variable. It should be a pointer variable and that's why it holds the address of another ordinary variable. Now let's start with our main concept, pointer and 2D arrays. How to access 2D array or a matrix with the help of pointer? Basically, a formula is used to access the elements of 2D array. Is nothing but we are going to deal with the base address, we are going to use the row index, the number of columns count also will require, as well as the column index is also required. How we are going to use this? Now in this program, in our program, the matrix is declared here itself. We are going to access all the array elements to display it in the matrix form. As discussed over here, the base address is nothing but the name of the matrix. As base address of array is used as pointer variable and name of array is a constant pointer, points to the first elements of array. With the help of this concept, we are going to use matrix as the name of the array. Plus I is nothing but the row index into number of columns, they are declared over here with the help of macro 3 in our example. J is nothing but the column index which we are going to access. With this formula, we are going to access all the elements of our matrix. How the address will get calculated, how they are going to be used, that I am going to explain in next slide. So let's move forward how the address will get calculated. Let's start with a simple example where the matrix of index 0, 0 and its elements we need to access. Internally, compiler performs the operation with the help of formula, evaluate the address available with its base address plus its row and column position. The I is nothing but the row index, columns are nothing but the number of columns plus j. With this formula, ith row and jth column we are going to access. In this example, we want to access 0 and 0, that is row 0 and column 0 element. So that's why I will get replaced with 0. J will get replaced with 0 again. Number of columns are 3 and matrix is nothing but its base address is 65510. So at the end, value available at the address 65510 is nothing but 1. The same task is done by the compiler internally when we are going to use the matrix with its subscripts, the row position and the column position. Let's go through another example. If we want to access the 0, 1 element of the matrix. So the same formula again, matrix is gets replaced with its base address. I, the row index 0 is given over here. Number of columns are 3 and J is nothing but the column index, that is 1. This calculation is done as it will result into 1. Here this multiply by 2 is nothing but the multiplication with 2 bytes, as to store every element in the matrix it requires 2 bytes. We are assuming that every element requires 2 bytes to store that into the memory. So that's why we are multiplying it by 2. After calculation of this, it will become 2 and it will get added with its base address, is nothing but 65512, and value available with the address 65512 is nothing but 2. Is nothing but the index 0, 1 and value available at the address is nothing but 2. So, let's move forward for next example. The 1, 2 index is provided, row 1 and column 2. Same thing, I is replaced with 1, J is replaced with 2. This calculation is nothing but 5. 5 is multiplied by 2 as 2 bytes are required to store every element. And at the end, the calculation will get the result as the address 65520. And the value available at the 65520 is nothing but 6. And let's verify the index is available is nothing but 1, 2. And the last example, you can calculate like this. And with the help of this formula, you can access any of the element which is available in our array. Now, next we'll move forward. Purely, if you want to use pointer variable in our program, what we need to do. Now, let's see this program where we are not going to declare any matrix over here. But for declaration of matrix, we are going to use somehow malloc function. How the malloc function is going to work, that we'll explain in next slide. But now, currently, this 4x3 is given over here, is declaring an array of 4x3 size, and with the help of first nested for loop, we are going to accept the values which are available or which we want to access from the user. With the same formula, it's base address plus I into number of columns plus J. And with the next two nested for loops, we are going to display all the values with the same thing. A separate pointer variable is declared. All tasks are done with pointer variable and memory is allotted according to requirement. Memory allocation is compulsory. Without this program will not work. Now let's see how the memories get allotted. What is malloc function? Here we need to declare a pointer variable P with which the memories get allotted. Malloc function is used to allocate a memory dynamically. At the runtime, the memories get allotted for the given size. How many bytes required is need to pass as a parameter to function malloc. So here we have declared the 4 number of rows, 3 number of columns, all of our type integer. So that many bytes we need to allocate. This malloc function returns a null pointer by default, but by rule, data type of pointer variable and the data of variable whose address we need to store in a pointer variable should match. For this reason, we need to typecast the address type of allotted memory from null pointer to integer pointer. This is done with the help of this bracket. Bracket integer pointer is nothing but the typecasting of the address location. Here we are using the size of matrix 4x3 as of type integer, and now at the end this malloc function allocates a chunk of memory required for 4x3 matrix and it returns only its base address in the pointer variable P. So now P is holding only the base address. Now let's see how the memory is allotted while or all the elements are accessed while execution of the above statement or while execution of the previous program. So now this for I is equal to 0, J is equal to 0, the memories get allotted with P plus 0 into 3 plus 0 and memories get allotted as well as the values get used accessed over here. In this way, the same way J is incremented by 1 for row 0. Next, J is incremented by 1 for the same row. For row 1, J is 0, J is 1 and J is 2. Simultaneously, addresses are also going to be updated. And remaining All the address locations are accessed in the same way.